Crucified. O God, into your mystery, we dare to enter this evening of suffering and death. Give us ears to hear once again the power and beauty of a love that surrendered everything and sacrificed all on this day we call Good Friday. Stir in us such love as we seek to live in your spirit. Claimed by your courage and strength, move us beyond our fear. Help us as we dare to follow you wherever you may lead us this evening. Jesus said, "When I am lifted up from the earth, I will draw all people to myself." Blessed be the name of the Lord our God. For us and for our salvation, Christ became obedient unto death, even death on a cross.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Let us pray. Almighty God, we pray you graciously to behold this your family, for whom our Lord Jesus Christ was willing to be betrayed and given into the hands of sinners and to suffer death upon the cross. Grant that while we trace Jesus's path of sighs and tears, our hearts may be so touched with contrition and repentance that we may be ready to embrace with joy all the crosses and sufferings of our own lives. Through Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Thank you. Jesus is condemned to death. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you.
Because by your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
As soon as it was morning, the chief priests and the elders and scribes and the whole council held a consultation. And they bound Jesus and led him away and delivered him to Pilate. And they all condemned him and said, "He deserves to die." When Pilate heard these words, he brought Jesus out and sat down on the judgment seat at a place called the pavement, but in the Hebrew, Gabbatha. Then he handed Jesus over to them to be crucified.
Down the field, over us, upon the way.
God did not spare his own son. Let us pray. Almighty God, whose most dear son went not up to joy, but first he suffered pain and entered not into glory before he was crucified, mercifully grant that we, walking in the way of the cross, may find it none other than a way of life and peace through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. Amen.
Jesus is nailed to the cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
When they came to the place which is called the skull, there they crucified him. And with him they crucified two criminals, one on the right, the other on the left, and Jesus between them. And the scripture was fulfilled, which says, he was numbered with the transgressors.
Thank you.
They pierce my hands and feet. Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, you stretched out your arms of love on the hard wood of the cross that everyone might come within the reach of your saving embrace. So clothe us in your spirit that we, reaching forth our hands in love, may bring those who do not know you to the knowledge and love of you for the honor of your name. Amen.
Jesus dies on the cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
It was now about the sixth hour, and there was darkness over the whole earth until the ninth hour. And the sun was darkened, and the curtain of the temple was torn in the middle. Jesus cried with a loud voice, said, "It is finished. Father, into your hands I commend my spirit." Then, bowing his head, he handed over his spirit.
Thank you.
Christ for us became obedient unto death.
Even death on the cross.
Let us pray. O God, who for our redemption gave your only begotten Son to the death of the cross, and by his glorious resurrection delivered us from the power of our enemy, grant us so to die daily to sin, that we may evermore live with him in the joy of his resurrection, who lives and reigns now and forever. Amen.
Jesus is laid in the tomb. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
When it was evening, there came a rich man from Arimathea named Joseph, who was also a disciple of Jesus. He went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. Then Pilate ordered that it be given to him. And Joseph took the body and wrapped it in a clean linen shroud and laid it in his own new tomb, which he had hewn in the rock. And he rolled a great stone to the door of the tomb.
I shall say.
You will not abandon me to the grave. Let us pray. O God, your blessed Son was laid in a tomb in a garden and rested on the Sabbath day. Grant that we who have been buried with him in the waters of baptism may find our perfect rest in his eternal and glorious kingdom, where he lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you.
Be our light in the darkness, O Lord, and in your great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the love of your only Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
The cross will always represent the this night, as we lovingly remember the death of our Lord Jesus Christ, let us bring the needs of the whole world to the foot of the cross of Christ. Grieving God, your Son embraced death even as he had embraced life, faithfully and with good courage. Grant that we who have been born out of his wounded side may hold fast to our faith in him exalted and may find mercy in all times of need. The body of Christ broken in the world of violence, we pray. Reconcile those who are estranged, console those who suffer, and raise up to new life all that is bound by death. Christ our God, your love is poured out in the death for our sake. Hold us in your embrace as we wait for Easter's dawn. Comfort us with the promise that no power on earth, not even death itself, can separate us from your love. And strengthen us to wait until you are revealed to us in all your risen glory.
We thank you, Heavenly Father, that you have delivered us from the dominion of sin and death and brought us into the kingdom of your Son. And we pray that, as by his death he has recalled us to life, so by his love he may raise us to eternal joys, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Praying together. O God of peace, who has taught us that in an eternity rest we shall be saved, in quietness and confidence shall be our strength. By the might of your Spirit, lift us, we pray, to your presence, where we may be still and know that you, O God, through Jesus Christ,